Hello from Portland. I'm back. Had a nice little break up here. A few things I was trying to work on. I'm gonna get a charging device for the solar house batteries because, you know, up in Portland when it's all overcast like this, it's really hard to get solar power. So I'm gonna go down today to AM Solar, the guys that hooked me up with the awesome solar package that I have, and I'm gonna hopefully learn how to install this thing. But first, we're gonna stop by the UPS store and send out some cookies to some friends and helpful people. That was complete, easy. I even got a frequent shipper card because I have sent so many cookies through the same UPS store. All right, gotta get ready and hit the road. So I'm over at AM Solar with Cody, and it turns out we have a little detour yet again. We're trying to figure out how to hook in the fancy word charger, right? It's an alternator regulator. And so it looks like I'm gonna have to come back tomorrow morning and sort this out. So I'm gonna go say hi to Garrett, the president, and maybe I'll get into some fun after this, who knows?
So it sounds like you're gonna need
there we go. 100 watts of solar. So that's Garrett. Say hi, Garrett.
Hi.
Garrett. He's at the top dog over here at AM Solar. So I think we came up with a solution for my battery issue. And actually, it could be a product that they might start selling in the near future. And I think I'm gonna be camping here tonight. So I'm gonna go someplace, and it might involve hot springs. Must say, Danny Adventure Bus is looking pretty darn good. It looks like, it should be in a catalog for like Urban Outfitters or something. I mean, it's definitely hipster in here. We definitely have the Navajo theme going on in the back if you guys haven't noticed. So yeah, it makes me feel good that, you know, along with being functional, that, you know, it's stylish and, you know, it looks nice. It's important to me. All right, I'm going back to my home away from home on the road, which is good old-fashioned Walmart. I need to pick up some lunch, which I'm probably just gonna get baby food, and some other supplies because I have been stationary for the past week, and I don't have any food in Dan the Adventure Bus. He's hungry. So I got myself 16 pouches of baby food. Let me show you a $4 meal, which is an amazing meal when you're doing a road trip because eating a sandwich can sometimes, as you know, become a very messy ordeal. You end up wearing it. So check this out, $4 right here, 98 cents a piece. Oregon, no sales tax, love you Oregon. Check out the ingredients on these things. Like, how healthy is this? Organic apple, pear, brown rice, and vitamin C, man. Bang, boom, organic. I mean, if anybody knows a healthier $4 meal on the road or inside Walmart, for God's sakes, please let me know, because I think I found it. Look at this one, apple, sweet potato, carrot, lemon juice, and vitamin C. Like, it's amazing. Not a great source of protein, but, you know, pretty healthy on the go food. Need to lose a couple pounds. You know, I think my new favorite gas station is the ones connected to the grocery stores. Out here, they're called Fred Meyer. Over in Utah, I think it's also a Smith's, it's Kroger, a bunch of different names. We get 3 cents off a gallon if you're in the rewards thing. And I know it might not be like exciting to everyone else, like it is so exciting to me right now. But when you times it by 50 gallons or 55 gallons, like 3 cents kind of adds up, like to $1.50. That's another container of baby food right there. So anyways, maybe it's not so exciting or such a great deal, but I mean, this diesel is so freaking expensive. Makes me second guess my choice in getting a short school bus and not something more fuel efficient like a Sprinter van or something. Update on where I'm going. I have no idea, but I am gonna drive next to this really pretty Mackenzie River, and I don't know, maybe I'll just go for a hike or something. There's some hot springs like kind of far up the way, but they look kind of fancy and I like more like rugged kind of hot springs, so I don't know, we'll have fun, we'll do something. I'm really glad that I listened to my Aunt Patty and decided to check out the Mackenzie River, so thank you, Aunt Patty, for the heads up. And thank you, Garrett and Cody over at AM Solar for pointing me in this direction, because, man, this is quite the magnificent view up to the hot springs up here. So, yeah, just enjoying the view. It's amazing. And if you guys haven't checked it out, I would definitely suggest this, even if you're just gonna do the drive. It's incredible, but there's a lot of places to stop and you know, just appreciate the beautiful view up here. Well, just pulled over to check out something called the Good Pasture Bridge. I got the big camera out to do some photos. I'm gonna try and get Dan the adventure bus inside it and take a picture of it, but it's a one lane kind of thing, and I don't want to be a dick and, I mean, block traffic, but there is no traffic out here, so I think I'm gonna do it. Look at this river. Look at how pretty it is. It's a lot of water flowing out there right now. Definitely not a good time to swim, and it's freezing. Turned off the highway and onto Belknap Springs Road, and I don't know what other words to say other than it's freaking beautiful out here. You know what I mean? Look at this. It's awesome. So the springs is right there. Overflow parking looks like it's right there. Give me a few minutes and we'll find out where to park. Well, that was easy. Just park at the bottom of the hill. Oh, look, they got big old spots for big vehicles. Actually, they're not, but whatever. It should work. I gotta say, holy guacamole. Looks amazing. Springs look like they're behind me. That large building. The river is right here, as you can see. And it's gonna be 15 bucks unless they wanna give it to me for free, but sometimes I feel like a mooch if I ask for free stuff too often, so probably just gonna pay, lay low, and relax, jump in the water. Well, the time is now. Paid my 15 bucks, $2 for a rented towel, because I forgot mine, and it's time to jump in the water. Whew, well. Been chilling in the hot tub in the hot springs for about an hour. 15 bucks all day pass, or $8 an hour, $2 for a towel if you forget one. We're gonna take a little break though. This is pretty amazing. All right, I am finished. And you know what I learned? Remember when I stopped at IKEA on my way to Los Angeles and I bought two towels? Well, two towels just got $2 more expensive because I forgot they existed. Anyways, as always, I had a nice time in the hot springs, and this was definitely my least favorite hot spring besides the one in New Mexico, which did not exist. The only reason being, this seems to be a chlorinated hot spring. My hands smell like chlorine. If I wanted to go in chlorinated water, I would jump in a hot tub. Anyways, not to complain, but you know, I want the all natural experience. This by far was not that natural. Anyways, still nice though. Was it worth 15 bucks compared to the other hot springs I stopped at? I wouldn't say so. Now pulled over next to the Mackenzie River, and I can hear the river flowing from the bus. Let's see if you can hear that. I would guess I'm maybe 30 feet from the river. 20 feet? I'm not really sure. Right on the edge, basically, of the road. The guys at AM Solar were super nice and offered me to a space to park overnight on the property. But, you know, I'm in a van down by the river. So I might just stay here, even though it's on the side of the road. All I know is that I'm hungry. And what do we have in the kitchen? Oatmeal, baby food, more baby food. Oh, look, we got sardines. Tonight, the dinner is sardines.